got my own little garage and everything.
Don't know how you did it. If I had to spend every day working on the board's machinery, I would have gone spare.
I don't think I belonged, really. Folks tried to treat me nice, but we didn't understand each other.
I'm glad the boss picked you up. Crew wouldn't be the same without you.
That's real sweet, Felix. Right back at ya.
Go! Now that was fun! With you, boss.
You ever want to hide a body? You could dump it in that sulfur pool.
I don't got much use for sulfur in my own work. Neat that it's here, though.
Heads up, boss!
Looks like my kind of town.
I don't like the way folks are looking at me, Captain. I got my sandwich. Maybe I could stand a little closer to you.
Make a run with me to Stella Bay.
Uh-huh. You blind, fella? Or can you not see I'm busy? Why is it every sissy pig fucker who strolls into my town expects me to smile and shout awful friendly? Welcome to Fallbrook. Only nugget of paradise in this entire law-forsaken land. Like a void damn advert.
I could listen to her talk for hours.
Truthfully spoken, I do aim to properly represent my aforementioned nugget of paradise. You know, I ain't heard that one before. Suppose I'll have to work harder to show you just what makes our town shine. But first, I'll need to know what brings you, stranger. Well, I'm half listening. Good of you to finally haul your ass over here. I wired for backup weeks ago. Got something that's gonna require special extraction from Cascadia. Special as in unlawful, delicate, and deadly. As to the something, no, it ain't a person. Not this time. One of my runners uncovered a cache of Alta Vitae gas, left in a lab when the board abandoned Cascadia. To extract the gas, you'll need to siphon it from the lab in Cascadia into one of your ship's fuel tanks. Totally safe. I do like your gumption, but let's not be hasty. To get to the gas, you'll need to navigate through the town, which is overrun by marauders. The lab itself has become an infested nest, crawling with mantis. You gotta fight through or figure out some other way to exterminate them. Maybe the ventilation system? Clever! That's why Lilia's paying you, I take it. Now, after you clear the mantis nest and reach the storage room, all that's left is to get the gas flowing into the fuel system. The task will require someone with technical skills. Or you could force it through with a plasma overload. Don't recommend that option, though, unless you want to get dead.
Load vapors into a liquid propellant tank? I think I know how to do that? No, I can do that. I think. Yes. Mostly? Definitely.
Dandy. Did I mention the gas is of an extremely volatile nature? Handle it with the utmost of care. Once you've got our goods, take them to the groundbreaker. Lilia's fencers ought to handle the rest of it. I've marked the coordinates for you to the lab in Cascadia. Use the passcode Antediluvian on the terminal to get in. But before you make your run, I could use a heavy helping hand regarding a local issue. For a fine fee, of course. Good. This particular matter of opportunity has been eating at me for a while now. There's a Borst factory on up the way, run by a man who calls himself the King. Clive Lundberg, insufferable prick. That aside, it's a business ripe for the plucking. I want it. Clear as that. Stars, I hope so. Clive Lundberg, the self-proclaimed Borst King of Monarch, is swimming in profit and drowning in his ego. He's making the only meal to be had this side of Monarch, and I'm tired of ponying up for my dinner. I want that Borst factory, owner dead or alive. And you're the soon-to-be handsomely paid son of a bitch who's gonna get it for me. Guess you've got it figured out then. Good. Hit him where it hurts. In his gut or his production lines ought to make do. Then I'd say you might care to poison the cysty pigs, doctor a few financial records, or throw a wrench in the canning machinery. It'll be more than good when you're finished. Maybe not for Clive, but for me and you, I'm sure. Oh, and if you don't fancy going in guns blazing or crawling through a sewer pipe, see Duncan in the dry goods and sundry building. He ought to have an employee ID in that stash of illicit goods he keeps for select clientele. May luck be with you, since I won't be.
Catherine Malin could sour milk just by glaring at it.
You know how there's folk who are all... outside, but warm and squishy inside.
How's Clive? Sure. Might be I know something about it. Might be someone hired my crew to blind drop supplies on the Northern Bridge. Might be they sure as shit weren't pirates. Now that I consider it, I ain't heard from my delivery team in far too long. Find them for me, and I'll pay you handsomely. And I'll thank you kindly.
Must have been one ugly fight.
We ought to see if anybody's still alive. They might be too weak to call for help.
Stay back. I may be wounded, but I'm still armed. How'd you get past my traps anyway? Just remember, I still got bullets, in case you get any funny ideas. What are you doing out here anyway? That feels a mite better. Wish I had something to give you, but I gnawed through my last spratwurst an hour ago. A cave like this makes a handy place to store goods or hide out for a spell. And the traps usually keep gawkers out. Catherine had us making drops for some big shot client out here. And before you ask, I don't know who they are. Or were. The whole point of making drops in the middle of nowhere was to keep their identity and whereabouts a secret. The Marauders knew we were coming. Rigged the bridge with explosives and everything. If they found us, my guess is they found the client too. Last I saw, they were heading back up the hill. You'll see it on the right when you get out of here. If you've got the sand to go after him, I'm sure Catherine can reward you for your trouble. Me? I'm headed back to Fallbrook just as soon as I've caught my breath.
So, you got that?
Thank you. seen Arthur before?
Damn. Last time I saw him. God, I can't remember. Days.
You don't think he got crushed during the bridge collapse?
It was his thing. It puts things into perspective.
Mind your own business, friend. Mind your own business, friend.
Where are we headed?
Mind your own business, friend.
Here they come! Thank you.
here.
Gotta get past that elevator! Wonder if we'll find any grisly experiments in here.
Proximity alert. Biology human. Protocol kill all mans. Suspended. Attempting to disengage security protocols without proper authorization is a fireable offense. Priming weapons.
You don't want to shoot us. We're from the board. Real distinguished corporate jackasses we are. Yeah.
Mediocre verbal evasion detected. Threat level downgraded to negligible. Weapons disengaged.
It's nothing, boss. All I had to do was ask myself, Felix, what would a real certified corporate bootlicker say in this situation?
Be advised. Mantasaur threat level is petrifying purple berry. Please use caution. Mantasaur wounds are not covered under Rizzo's health policy. Have a productive day.
Gotta siphon off the Alta Vitae.
Thank you.
I'm thinking, if I patch this into our fuel cell network, we can use the empty tanks to hold this ultra-wada-vittle stuff. Just gotta compensate for the pressure difference. We burn liquid reaction mass, not gas. And the cells are distributed all through the hull, so I gotta isolate the empties. Of course I did, Captain. Just gave it a little jiggle. There we are. Good as pretty and twice as new. Oh, I just did my thing. You know.
That's some top shelf work, Parvati. Hey, I remember Cascadia from that one episode of Terror on Monarch. Crawling with monsters it was.
What would it like to clean this place? Before it was all boarded up. It lit up the night.
Jackass isn't coming!
We've arrived at the Groundbreaker. Stay safe out there.
CMP near maple syrup. It's impressive.
That gas is going to make us a fucking mint. 120-some cubic meters of it, at a million bits a pop. Take this. You've earned it. When we get buyers lined up, I'm gonna buy a gold toilet to shit in. You're goddamn right. Monarch isn't exactly a walk down the lanes of Byzantium. But here you are with all your limbs attached. Call me impressed, contractor. No one you saw, anyway. Glad to see you're looking out for yourself. I hope you kept the Unreliable's engines warm, because I got another job lined up for my new favorite contractor. You're gonna salvage me a space station. Heliospheric Research Station 1084, to be exact. I want it. Cobwebs and all. Interested?
We're gonna take over a whole space station? This is gonna be great! Oh, do we get to stick a flag in the ground?
This opportunity won't come around again, Captain. Here, this override bypass should get you into the station systems where you can plant my flag. And one last thing. When you get there, make sure you aren't followed. We wouldn't want that. I'm on the heels of something big. Play your cards right and I'll clue you in, but right now, I'm not sure who I can trust. Just be careful. Someone might try and use you to get to me.
We're now in orbit above Fallbrook, Captain.
What do you want?
Oh, hey, Vicar Max. What are you doing on Monarch? I thought scientitians ain't welcome here.
Haven't you heard? Everyone's welcome here. It's a fucking worker's paradise. But you wouldn't know anything about that, would you? Never worked a day in your miserable life. You're just a parasite, living off my goodwill. Well, guess what? My goodwill's exhausted, along with my temper. This is the guy who told me about the book while we were in prison. I lied about finding a scholar. But I don't care about any of that anymore. I just want to inflict massive amounts of pain on this guy.
Wait, wait, wait! I know who can translate the book for you.
It's too late for that. I threw away my life chasing fairy tales. Will punishing you fix any of that? Of course not. But by law, it will make me feel a whole lot better. Forget it. This wretch will say anything to save his worthless life.
Wait, stop! Please, just listen to me. It was stolen from some sort of expert on philosophism. Weird hermit lady on Scylla. My father used to deliver supplies to the mining outpost there.
I don't think so. Fine. We've got more important things to do anyway.